Crossfire YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe. In today's video, we want to look at Einstein's postulate on the theory of relativity, that is the special theory of relativity. Now, it follows that from the Galilean transformation, which we have considered in some of our previous videos, that it really tells us, if you look at that, it tells us that what? That velocity of light is relative in a way. And there are some other things that we consider in Galilean transformation. Now, one of the things you need to look at really is the velocity of light. That is why Einstein had to come in. After the failure of the Joseph Mollie experiment to determine the speed of the Earth, you know, that's one of the claims of relativity. Even ever before Einstein came into to state the special postulate, it has always been believed that you cannot determine what your speed in your frame of reference. You cannot determine your absolute speed as an inertial body, a body that is moving in an inertial frame of reference, which is what a frame of reference whose velocity is constant. Now, so just so that this thing can continue like that, you know, that it was because of the claim of Galilean transformation that the speed of light is going to be relative. That was why Michelson and Mollie tried to carry out an experiment to determine the speed of what? Of the Earth, which should not be possible to do. Now, and if you can watch some of the videos, you can watch that very video on the Joseph Mollie experiment. Everything is there, both the mathematics and the result of it, and the meaning. I also talk about why the experiment failed. So, but today, we are going to talk about what Einstein's postulate on relativity. So, his postulate follows from that the failure in that very experiment, which was the Mollie experiment. Namely, number one is that the postulate are these just two postulates, which might not be, it does not come from what? From mathematical proving or, but in the long run, when we look at Lorentz transformation and the rest, we discover that what? Those things can be proven mathematically. The first postulate is that the laws of physics are the same for all inertial observers. That is, what does that mean? That the laws of physics are the same for all inertial observers. Now, it says that what? If you are in your frame of reference and you are moving at a constant velocity, that means the law of physics should work for you. And if I am doing the same, it should also work for me. Whether I am moving at 100 km per hour or you are the one moving at maybe 300 km per hour, it should surely work for the both of us. Now, that is the first theory, that's the first postulate, that the laws of physics are the same for all inertial observers. So if you stay in your frame of reference, I stay in my frame of reference, we should get the same results when we test these laws of physics. Now, the second one is, it was so cooked up so that you cannot determine your absolute velocity. It follows from the failure of Michelson Mollie experiment. This one says that what? That the speed of light is not relative. The speed of light is not relative. What does that mean? Another statement of that is that what? The speed of light is constant. It is constant. And it is what? It is absolute. So let's say, for instance, you are in a vehicle. You are in a vehicle, or let's say you are in a train. You are moving, and then you have a light source, right? You're moving at a speed v relative to me. This is me. You're moving relative to me at a speed what? V. Now, and then let's say you have a light source, and suddenly there's a flash of light in your frame of reference. Now, that light, if let's say the light, since you are moving in this direction, and then the light also moves, the photons of light move in this direction. Now, according to Galilean transformation, what you should see is that what? if I am sitting here, I am standing here, and you are here, you will see the speed of light to be what? To be C, because it is your frame of reference. But what should I see? I should see what? C plus V. Now, Einstein says that what? This is not correct. That is not the right way to go about it. That what? The speed of light should be the same for me and the same for you, even if you are the one carrying the light. If I was the one that was with the light, according to Einstein, according to Galileo, how are you supposed to see the speed of light? Let's say the light is with me now. Now, I put on the light in this direction. Since this very train is moving relative to me with the speed V, so it should see this light as what? As V minus, as what? C minus what? V. Since E is already moving in that direction, so that is the way it is. But Einstein says that what? This should not be so. That what? The speed of light should remain C, both for me and for you, no matter the speed you are moving with. And this also, this is where we now, let me chip in something. You must also know that what? You cannot travel faster than light. In fact, you cannot travel as fast as light can travel. Now, all speed, you will see that when we talk about the Lorentz transformation, because they have made a video on Lorentz transformation, but I want to make another very good video that will explain Lorentz transformation in a better way that we understand, and we consider both transformation of coordinates, transformation of velocities, and we look at the implication and what it all means. So I believe you have really learned from this video. Do not forget to subscribe and share this video if you think it has been helpful.